Hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains on YouTube, and I'm working a lot of the yard jobs this summer. In this video, I'm going to talk about what engines we use and why we use those engines. The first thing I can tell you as an engineer is I have almost no control over what engines we use. The yard master tells me where my engines are located and which ones to use. And a lot of this is out of his control because the engines are decided by the Power Bureau. What engines do we use? Well, it's going to be a combination. We're going to have everything from GP38s, GP40s, GP40-2, MP15s, and so on. But that's what you're going to find mostly in the yard. It's almost always going to be four-axle power. Most of these engines are set up for RCO, that means remote control operators. That is when the conductor has the control pack on his chest and he is controlling the movement of the engines. With an RCO, all you need is one engine to be RCO controlled, and then he can make any additional units controlled by that RCO engine. You can tell that by the yellow strobe light that's on top of the engines. Here we see the 2246 and the 6458, also known as a mother and slug. Crazy names. Okay, so the 2246, which we see here, is really listed as a road mate or a road slug. And what's interesting, if you notice along the side, there are no doors. The reason why? There's no engine in it. That's solid concrete on the inside. Look closely. Notice a lot of the roof details because there is no engine or prime mover in this. Now the wheels are, you know, known as traction motors. They require electricity to move. And where does it come from? You see all the wires connecting the two engines? Okay, and all the cables connecting the two engines. How this works is the 6458, that's the mother. That has a diesel engine or a prime mover, which creates electricity. It's basically a power plant on wheels. So the 6458 provides the electricity, provides electricity for both units. They work in sync of each other, and most of the time these engines are married for life. They are MU'd, multiple unit. They are MU'd together pretty much permanently. It's very rare that you'll see them switched out. So it's interesting running these because if you're in the 6458, you'll hear the engine running. As an engineer, that we go off with sound a lot. And when you're running from the slug, you just hear the banging and just this like electrical, it's kind of like an electrical noise. It's hard to describe, but they have totally different sounds when you're running them. These engines are old. They're from the 70s, like me, and even the early 80s. This is former B&O engine. Now, we also use these on the locals. Here it is returning back from the salt plant. You can always tell the salt train by the amount of rust on those cars. Four-axle engines work really good in some industries where six-axle engines are prohibited. Now, although they're not the most powerful engines we have, I've had two GP40s one time pull over 10,000 tons on a flat. So yes, they can pull. They are meant for lower speeds. I believe most of the road slugs we have are converted from former engines. That's why you may still see fuel tanks on the slugs, even though it will probably be stenciled as "Do Not Fuel." There is also no way to transfer fuel from the slug to the mother. And I don't know if any of this exists in HO or N scale or O scale. I don't remember seeing a slug in N scale. Now you can leave comments if I'm wrong or if you have any suggestions on how to scratch build or kit bash a road slug. But I hope you enjoyed this video. I have a lot more videos coming up. How about after this, you go back and watch some of my older videos where I cover some of the industries that we work and a lot about life as an engineer and the different yards. And I'll be doing some more modeling videos. But subscribe to my channel and follow me on my website, djstrains.com, and Facebook and Twitter and Instagram. I got a lot of, so much footage. Tell you, I'll give you a sneak peek. You ready? Ooh, how pretty. All right, that's a special one. So here is all the links. You can click away. These links are good for you. Teach you stuff. Good for your health. They're gluten-free. No calories. You still watching this? Just click the links.